We have already configured our Git in our local environment in our PC, and the next thing that we need to do is we need to find some version control system that we can use with our project. So for that we'll be using GitHub. So let's go to GitHub here, github.com, and we need to sign up first and we need to create our account. So let's go and create an account first. So let's give a username first and let's give an email, then let's set a password. Just sign up for GitHub. Okay, verify your account. Okay, touch the arrow to move it. Yeah, this is a correct fit. That's done. Okay, good. So we'll use a free account over here. So select the free account, or if you want to go for pro account, then you can see what are included. Okay, that's it, and we'll select continue. That's it. So let's submit this one. Yeah, we are done, and you can see we have a learn Git and GitHub without any code. So we have a GitHub ready over here. And the what we need to do is we need to create a repository before we can use it. So just click on start new project or new repository. So start new project over here. So before we can use, we need to verify our email address. So let's go and verify email our address and let's come back. Okay, now it says our email address is verified, and you can see over here create a new project over here. So let's say we want to create a new project and the repository name would be my blog dash web. So it's for a web, and later we can create same for a Android. So let's give a description. This is my blog demo app. Okay, and let us say whether you want to create a private or public. So you can see, and let's everyone view our repository, and let's create a project over here. Got it. And that's it, our project, our repository is up. And what we need to do is we need to configure some of the things. That let's say we need to do Git init. Let's go to our project over here, not the Android. Let's open our, we need to open PhpStorm. So let's open our project. So this is our web, my blog dash web. So we need to open our PhpStorm for it. Okay, let's type our first command, which would be git init. So that means to initialize a git. So let's say git, let's say first git and see whether I have a command. Yeah, this git is working. And what we need to do second is git init. So this means that git is in a slice here over here. You can see C drive champ htdoc my blog that git. So if you go over here and let's go to C drive champ, and let's go to htdoc, and go, let's go to my blog over here, and you can see, okay, here you cannot see because it's hidden. So if you say unhide, you can see git in slice over here. So the next thing is the next command that we need to run is git.add readme.md. So let's, we don't have any readme.md. So what we need to do is we need to create. So let's go over here. Oh, sorry. Let's go to our, yeah, we can also create from here, and let's add a new file from here. New file, and let's say new file. Let's see. readme.md file. Let's create this one, and let's say add it, and let's say this each you can just type any demo web app. So later we can always update it. So for this now, let's see, this is our readme.md. So let's close it for now, and if you go over here you should see that file, so readme.md. So the thing that we need to run is here git add readme.md. So let's go over here and just run that command git add readme.md. Okay, that we have added. And the next thing, the next command is we need to commit. So let's run a command before this. So let's say git and status that in what will be committed. So what we need to do, we need to add all of this. So for that we need to run a command git add dot. So which means git add dot means we are adding everything that is inside our directory. So this directory, all the file that is inside this directory will be included in our git scope. So let's add everything and that's look fine. And the next thing we need to do is commit. Commit means we will commit the change that we are currently working on. So let's go and say git commit dash m, and let's say what is saying that it's the first commit or anything else that you want. Let's say it's the first commit. This would be our first commit. The spelling is gone F. And let's say enter. Failure unable to detect email address. So what we need to do is we need to set a global email address and also username. So for that we need to run a certain few commands. So let's go and set it. So let's add our username and our email address for our git. So let's run some command is git config, and that should be that's global global, and you should use user.name, and user.name it should be binary IT solution, and that's working good. And the next thing is we need to do is user.email, and we need to type our email address. So let us go over and set what was the email address that I used was and just paste email address over here and just say that's look fine. And now we can run our command which is git commit and the first commit. So let's go and say git commit dash m, and which means that we are adding the message is first commit, and you can see we have already added our files to a commit. So let's go and push it. So how we can push it? So the final command you can see git that push that you, so which means this will push all of our file to our GitHub. So let's go over here and let us run this command. Okay, so we think we made some mistake and we have to add, we did not run this command. So let us go back over here and we need to run this command. So let's just run this one. Okay, looks fine. And the next thing we need to run is git that push that. So we need to run our last command over here. And let's go and run this command. And just hold on a few seconds and let's see what it says. Okay, we need to log in. So let's log in. So let us log in over here and just hold on and let us see what's saying. So you can see it has pushed all of the files. So let's go and check our repository over here and let us go to my blog dash web, and you can see we have our one file which is index and readme. So it's also pushing up that IDE file, so we may not use it. Later we may remove it from git. So we have index, and you see we have a same file as here, And let's go back and see my project. And we have a, this is a demo app, web app, which is a readme.md file. It's the same file that we created over here, right? So hope you guys have some understanding on how it works. And if you have any queries or if you didn't understand anything, do let me know and I will try to fix it. And I'll try to create a new lecture on if you have any problem and understanding on it. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, have a great day.